This is a story about love. But it's not that typical love story. About the love for a beautiful woman, a child full of innocence, or even the love you feel for your mother and father. It's the kind of love between brothers. It gives you the will to do anything to protect the man that has your back. Amid the chaos, the violence, and the egregious sins, you covet that bond and hold it to be sacred.
You heard him. It's done.
This story begins where it ends.
Ginger Marianne.
Yeah. I'm gonna say Marianne.
I always pictured you as a ginger dude.
Yeah? Why is that?
Yeah. Just picture clean cut.
Yeah. Girl next door kind of thing?
Yeah, that's right. Marianne. Well, my style.
Yeah. I mean, Marianne's cool, but I get the sense she's gonna be a headache. You know what
like
I'm saying?
Like that, man? All up in my business.
It's the rhyme ruler, the mind of the master, the prime poet designed for disaster, a crime candidate, the light heavyweight. I might levitate right through the heaven's gate. Rhymes record break neck spines and vertebrae. Simple and plain like Kanye, I heard him say, it's murder one.
Mm-hmm. Can you go get her?
Mm-hmm. Mommy!
Yes, baby?
Can I help you?
You Sharon?
Yes. And you are?
Just a man holding up his end of the deal.
Deal?
A good man always holds up his end of the deal.
What deal? Wait! Who are you? What is this? Was that man? Was he hurt?
Yeah. No. I don't know, sweetie. Go into the kitchen.
Waking up this early is not getting easier. I gotta go somewhere warm.
Thank you. that water's cold.
Be a perk. Yoga pants.
You know, I really regret the day I gave you the keys to this thing, right?
Well, good morning to you too, Gordon. Wanna get something to eat?
Yeah, but, we gotta go see Fats first. Plus, I gotta get some gas. What?
To say you got issues is an understatement, man.
I got issues.
And why are you still wearing that cheap ass watch?
It was a gift. And it's reliable.
Let's just go, man.
Hey, open the damn car! Why the hell would you park in front of the driveway anyway?
Go ahead.
None of us gotta work.
Another great start to another great day.
You wanna do something?
Next time, don't blow your load on one shot.
This is for the car. This for the hospital. Next time, just do what the man says. Cut your ass.
You need help, okay? You need to talk to somebody. Seriously.
Whatever. I still need to get gas.
Unlock the door, sunshine.
Yeah. And I'm gonna use this recipe at the next barbecue, man. If I ain't know no better, I swear you had some black. Maybe some of that Southern Italian or something.
What was that supposed to
be? Well, you know I'm a history buff, right?
Yeah.
So, you know, the Moors of Africa moved in, took over, raped the women, and left some of that good seed in the peas, you know?
Is that so?
That's right.
Look, man, whatever you do, just don't burn the chicken. Right.
Big Rich, what's up, brother?
Yeah, doing all right. You know, busting my balls every day. Don't have much to show for it, but it'll all work out. Hey, Pat's inside waiting for you. Let's go.
Boss, through here. Jesus, H. Christ. You know, this fashionably on time stuff is a little bit over the top.
Yo, Clyde, don't you get yourself a donut or anything like that?
Personally, I don't need the crap. In a minute can be the difference between shooting and getting shot. But you know something? Maybe I'll start to consider it, boss.
Maybe you should. You are a compulsive son of a bitch. You're lucky I like you.
Well, you do good work. Here's your job.
It's gonna be 12 o'clock sharp. He comes home for lunch. I listen to you two. Don't want any lollygagging, no mistakes. You understand?
So, apartment? This one looks like it's right up your alley.
You can read it in the car. Do you mind? Go get the work, please.
Later, boss.
Fat said it's a one-man job on the inside. Who's gonna go in?
Shoot for it.
You got your pasty white ass.
All right, let's do it. 1, 2, 3, shoot. Oh, evens. I told you all the time, bet on evens.
It's your turn, soldier boy.
Oh, looks like it's time to go to work and keep the engine running for me, right, sweetheart?
Who the hell are you? What are you doing here?
Really, Tom? Are we gonna play this game?
If you don't get out of here, I'm gonna call the cops.
Do I look?
Swear to God, I'm gonna call the cops.
Like a guy who really gives a damn about the cops.
Dude, I'm not kidding. Oh.
Tom.
My freaking nose, man.
Thought I told you we weren't gonna play that game.
Where the hell is the money?
I don't know where the money is.
I don't know where Bad's money is.
Now, Tom, I asked you a clear question, you piece of trash. You open your mouth again, and it better be with the words I want to hear. I swear to God, I will take your teeth out one by one. Not if you understand.
I understand.
Now, Tom, I thought I told you how this was going to work.
I got so fat, it's funny. I got about 6 grand. It's at the train station. It's in a locker. I'll get the rest to him.
But your debt's 10.
I'll get it to him. You know, I got family. I got kids. I got a wife. I got so much debt. I gotta get it to him. I'll get it to him, I swear. I'll get it to him in a month, please.
All right, I'll let him know. Your time just ran out. Besides, now your wife can collect the insurance policy.
Dad, Mom!
well, well. Stop and make a snack, why don't you?
It's complicated.
Not too complicated to make a bag of popcorn. And is that microwave?
There was a child in there, all right?
Didn't.
No, I didn't.
Because you know the rules.
Look,
absolutely
I know
no
the
children.
Damn rules. All right, can we just get the hell out of here?
You, Tommy's little girl, right? Nobody's home but you. Just you and your dad. Nobody else, right? Listen, sweetheart, why don't you come sit with me on the couch, all right? Why don't you sit here, sweetheart, and get comfortable? I'll go make you some popcorn. Would you like that? Daddy had somewhere he had to go. And he won't be back for a while. But he said that I should get you comfortable until your mommy gets home, okay? And he also said, don't go down that basement for any reason. And that you didn't see me, understand?
Why? I think you're very nice.
Well, because I'm one of Daddy's special friends that nobody can see and nobody can know about. Because if you do tell, he and I can't be friends anymore. You wouldn't want that, would you?
No.
Alright, that's a good girl.
Can we just get the hell out of here?
Kid got you all messed up, huh? It's not good, bro.
No, the kid does not have me messed up like that. But we should have had the intel going inside that there was a child. Now you know that.
The Rev. Let's go.
A demon than I am.
I want suffering. Your suffering.
I spent a lot of days. Hey, it's me. Just checking in. Hope everything's alright. Covered in this malaise that I just can't shake. Sunday suit, taking that desperate walk through the graveyard of my youth. She was a perfume dream in the midst of my misery, but she went too far.
No evidence.
Beside my car, and he's looking at me like I got a 30 or something.
Right.
And he's taking his good asshole time looking me over like a scumbag man-eater does. You know what I really hate about these cops these days? Is they act like you owe them some kind of respect just because they hide behind a badge and a baton.
That's right.
Yeah. So he says to me, give me one good reason not to write you this speeding ticket. So I look at him and I say, well, I was married once. Didn't quite work out. Matter of fact, brought nothing for a cop but just like you. So when I saw you in the rear view mirror, I stepped on the gas. I was afraid you were gonna try to bring that bitch back to me.
What did he say?
Nothing, man.
Nothing.
Yeah, he just tore it up and walked away.
That's a crazy ass story, man.
I'm hungry. Let's get a sandwich.
Glad that you jokers are here. A little job for you.
Deal with it.
Well, you know I don't really care for these personal type jobs, but it really goes against my every principle. And sometimes, you have to do them to allow business to continue to run as usual.
Let's cut to the chase, boss. You just said this was personal. What is it, family? Friends?
It's nothing like that. There's a senator. His name's John Thomas.
Oh, that's the dude that's on TV. He's talking about cleaning up the streets and all that.
That's the guy. He's the guy that keeps us clean and allows us to operate. So we have to do him a little bit of a favor.
So, how much is the gig?
20.
Can I do that?
Do you mind if I finish? It's actually 20 apiece. But this is a very, very serious job. I can't have any of your shenanigans on this. We have to get this done properly.
Whoa. 20 apiece? For this dope, I get a nickel job?
Are you unhappy with your job? Because McDonald's is hiring. You could go down there. You'll do the jobs that I give you, and you'll like it. Do you understand? Now, this job, it is a two-man job. It has to be done properly. The senator's daughter's been kidnapped by some people that are getting a little uncomfortable about all the campaigning he's been doing to clean up the city. It's making a lot of people nervous. We have to get her back. We might be able to use the help of the good Rev here to back you guys up. So I want you to stay in the area, have your phone on you, just in case we need you. You understand?
Look, boss, we good. No, we the best. But we don't have S's on our chest.
Well, you're going to today. So put your capes on, Clark and Bruce. Dude, this little political hussy is coming out of there one way or another. Good work.
So which one are you?
What are you talking about?
Clark and Bruce.
What?
I kind of consider myself more like Batman.
No,
you're more like Robin.
honey. I hurt you. And you know what? I made dinner for you. You'll love that. Guess what I made? Just for you. Huh? I'm actually strong enough to admit that I can be weak. What's wrong about that? Nothing. But these idiots won't understand it. I know you do.
You know, this guy, John, he's just humiliating me over and over again.
I can't stand this anymore. And I'm a fragile guy, you know?
I'm actually strong enough
on your knees. On your knees. Or I will blow your face over that wall. You turn backsplash and you mean.
Let me ask you something. Are you a religious man?
Huh?
Vince, is it?
Yes. Yes, I'm Vince. Look, I'm sorry, okay? Yeah. Tell Fats I'll have the money. Tell Fats I'll have the money. I just need a little more time, okay? It's not a problem. I have kids. I have a family.
Not a religious man.
Oh.
This would be a good time to start. Get up with blues.
Spanish mommy caramel complexion.
Oh, yeah.
Her swerving all the right directions. Love your attitude, mama taught that.
Abby.
You better keep your hands off my designer suit.
You don't show ID, you don't come in.
Watch it, my man. Little man walks with a pretty big stick.
I don't see no stick.
Hey, look at him.
I wouldn't do that if I was you boys.
Hey, boy. I see some things don't ever change.
Kev, you might want to check your drawers.
I hear from Dom, you boys need some heavy hitters. Let's take a walk around back. I got some new inventory in.
Come down.
Yeah, ain't she a beauty? Ain't she a beauty?
Joe, she is gorgeous.
And let's face it. With what you've been doing with our money, clearly. You are not a chess man. And for that, I am not going to be gentle. You see, you're a taker. Unfortunately, I'm a taker too. I'm not just going to take your life. I'm going to take your soul.
No.
Pride.
No. No.
And your dignity. This little piggy. This little piggy.
Demon.
This little piggy. What? He did. Sure is in a lot of pain. I suppose the time here is about done. I guess I have to meet you last rites. It's over for the scene.
Not scripture. It's a little something I wrote for my congregation. And it goes. Blessed be the man who enters the valley of the shadow of death.
blessed be he who relinquishes and cleanses his soul for the feet of God. For he...
Just kill me. Please, just kill me. Please.
Ascend. Repents before his hour of reckoning. Are you ready to repent, Vince? Shall we begin?
Entry?
Nah. Figured you walk straight up there like 5-0.
The old magic gun routine?
Know it.
I'll do a lot talking, got a Batmobile, I'm driving, I'll do a lot walking.
Let me get you inside. Once you in there, you're on your own. Don't go hellfire and brimstone on me, man, alright? Fat said he wants some of these dudes alive. They're good earners.
Look, if they cooperate, there won't be any reason for hellfire and brimstone.
Pinky ring shining with the new chain. Speed through the city like a Bruce Wayne. Yeah, I don't do a lot of talking. Got a Batmobile, I'm driving. I don't do a lot of walking. Woo! Pinky ring shining with the new chain. Speed through the city like a Bruce Wayne.
Look at this. You lost or something?
I think you're in the wrong section.
Yeah, well, you might be right about that. I believe you got something that belongs. That belongs to you. Yeah, Pat. Pretty little thing. I'm 5 feet tall. Long brown hair. 100 pounds soaking wet. Perfect.
Hey, look, white boy. I'm gonna need you to break out before I break my foot off in your ass.
I think that would be a very bad decision. Boys like magic?
Hey. Oh. Yes.
Oh, damn!
Look, do us both a favor, okay? Put away the BB gun, and maybe, just maybe, we're gonna walk out of here.
Is that so? Why don't you go ahead and go for that gun, so I can split you down into white.
Hey, white boy, the hell you think you gonna do with that thing except piss me off?
Just another scared suburban white boy, hiding behind a pistol.
Man, well, I grew up in Queens. My father beat the fear out of me before the streets ever could.
Whoa! Come on! Come on, father!
You see a badge?
And who the hell might you be?
So?
What brings you to our establishment?
Where's the girl?
So you think you can just come up in here, jack up my boys, and I'm just supposed to let you walk out of here? Funny thing is, white boy, almost respect your courage, coming in here by yourself.
Yeah, well, I do like to make an entrance.
She's right here. You know what? You can have her. I'm done with her.
Pig.
Say hi to daddy for me, baby. And you. So what do you think now, huh? You think I'm just gonna let you walk on out of here?
You wanna keep your boys.
Ah! That help? God damn it!
Make it on time.
Yeah, well, I told you, walk with a big stick. Plus, I like watching the violence.
Okay. Let's win her, you prick!
Get her off me, goddammit!
I didn't know she was down with the swirl. What's your name, brother?
Jamal. It's Jamal.
Okay, well, Jamal. We're gonna leave here with no problems. Can you dig it?
Yeah, man.
I asked you if you could dig it. I wonder if you say it before I make my boom stick, bust you down to the white meat. Fat says you're a good earner, so we're gonna let you live. But we're gonna leave here with no problems. Dig?
Yeah, man.
I don't wanna see you messing with any more snow bunnies. Can you dig her?
Yeah, man. Y'all are fat boys? Why did you say something, huh?
Like I'm Bruce Wayne.
All right, no problem. I don't do a
lot of talking. I have a good day now, you hear? I'm driving, I don't do a lot of walking.
If you started, I'm a pocket fresh. Is this the toenails that I asked for?
Absolutely.
All right, very good. But I thought I asked you to back the other two up.
Didn't think they needed it. Besides, they wasn't going to cut me in on that anyway.
You know what? You get the jobs that you're suited for. You have to stop sulking. You know what? You're a big baby. You gotta grow up a little bit, all right? Get the hell out of here. But yes, here's your next job.
Thank you.
All right, get out. Jesus, Mary and Joseph. If I knew I had to deal with all these sensitive types, I would have gotten myself a damn psychology degree. God.
How you feeling, Barney?
Yeah. Things ain't like they used to. Ribs are a little sore, but all right, I guess.
Don't you go making excuses before I'm tipping. I'll take your money. Sewing and popping, kid.
Yeah? About the only thing I think that's popping is the cartilage in those knees, brother.
You know what? I'm about to be slamming all over your head. You what?
You really think you can still lift off, huh? Small wager on it?
Too large.
Alright, you're on. But I'm gonna enjoy taking this money from you.
Kid, ball.
Sleep.
Yes, sleep. Oh, the boy is warm. How about we make this entry?
You got it. It's all even up now. Too large back on the table.
A little one-on-one?
You got it.
Alright. Follow me.
Hey. All city. You ain't impressed anybody
all
yet.
City.
All city. Ah. Hey.
us once it's back at the office. Pronto.
You sound pissed?
What you think?
Ready to behave, little Debbie?
Debbie, you assholes! Get me out of here!
I guess not. Nighty-night, princess.
These kids these days, boy, I tell you, they got no respect, you know?
Nah, no respect and no loyalty.
It's bad parenting, you know?
So I blame it on.
Bad parenting.
Ready?
Yeah.
Cease to amaze me.
Thanks, Richard.
What the hell is the matter with you?
Whoa, dumb. We got the job done. I mean, yeah, there were a few casualties, but just enough to keep the street rats in line.
Yeah, boss, in and out. No collateral damage.
It's not even what I'm talking about. Did the two of you stop to play a pickup game in between jobs?
What? Why is that? It's funny?
It's like I'm running a daycare here. I'm almost afraid to ask. Where is she now?
She's still in the trunk.
Well, get her out!
Jesus Christ, Richard! Take her back to her father. You two, make sure she doesn't see anything around here.
You two truly are amazing.
Get her out!
Let's go, little Debbie.
Focus.
Oh. What's going on? Oh, my mouth.
Some good coffee, man.
What?
I hope you don't mind me helping myself.
What?
You want some? I forgot. You're tied up. Now, it seems you're a little late for the rent this month.
What?
So, I think we should get to this. Normally, I would save this moment. As it stands, schedule.
What are you doing?
Lest be the man who walks through the valley, the shadow of death.
Wait!
Blah, blah, blah.
How long have we been working together?
About 5 years.
5 long years.
You know we met way before that though, right?
Yeah. How's that?
Remember that job you did about 6 years ago outside the Gatone warehouse?
Yeah, with Jimmy Tools and Rocco.
That's the one.
Fats was extending his territory. Things got a little messy. So how did me and you meet?
I was your backup. I was outside in the car.
That was you with the hair?
Get it all in.
Wait, I'm sorry. No, I'm digging the Professor X look you got. It suits you.
Yeah, well, that's about the time my OCD started to kick in anyway. Yo, you go to the cat house?
Ooh, show you right.
Look at this.
Hey, boys. Long time no see. Can I get you guys some drinks?
Get me something, sweetheart. Anything you want.
You got problems.
Yeah, one big problem. You know what I'm saying?
I guess it is. You want me to wait up for you, sweetheart?
Now you know you ain't got the stamina to wait up with me for.
Do you have any vacation time saved up for doing
this? I don't know. Think you can find me there?
Think so. Come on. Ladies, locker.
I didn't know I had to move out of the way of every man with an attitude.
Not a man with an attitude, a man with a purpose.
Purpose, huh? Same purpose that got a man beaten to death?
Exactly what is that supposed to mean?
You know exactly what I mean.
Hey, Light, who the hell are you hitting with?
Captain Marcus Stone. And I'm talking about Evan Jones. The same Evan Jones that doesn't have a father because of a reverend with an agenda.
Who the hell are you?
Just a man with a message.
What might that be?
Listen, I probably would have did the same thing. I truly understand what you did. Watching a kid get beaten by his father week after week, showing up at church with a black eye simply because he spilled milk or played a video game a little too long. Yeah, I probably would have beaten him too.
And that was a long time ago. Not to mention I was acquitted.
Now we all know that an acquittal doesn't mean innocence.
Neither does a little boy, too afraid, too frightened, to testify against his own father.
Good old street justice, huh? Carried out by a holy man who thinks this is right to exact justice.
Really like to step, Captain.
Oh, I will. And I'll be watching yours too. Oh, and by the way, where can I get one of those suits you got on? They seem to be all the rage around here nowadays.
Richard. It's me. We seem to have a bit of a problem.
You know what? I think you've been a bad boy. I was gonna have to discipline you.
Really? Don't
the day that a friend of mine had died. I laughed so hard, then I cried.
So what's going on out there?
I got a little visitor today.
Really? And who would this visitor be?
A one detective, Marcus Stone, says he wants to purchase a suit.
Stone. Richard, you know who this Stone is?
No, Dom. I never heard of him.
All right, well, find out what you can. See what you can find out. Tell the other guys, give them a call. Tell them to lay low for a little while until we figure this all out, all right?
You got it.
Okay, Mr. Reverend, you are dismissed.
Gentlemen?
Morty, wake up. Wake up.
Morty, you are one tough son of a bitch. Where's the stolen merchandise, Morty? What? I can't hear you.
I don't know what you're talking about, man. Merchandise.
Morty, let's not play these games.
Okay? Man, we're merchandise, man. Look, I don't know who you are, man. I'll give you what you want, man.
Anything.
Yeah, man.
Anything.
Yeah.
Anything like what?
You got it all, man. Women, booze, drugs, I got it, man. I got you. Just cut me down.
Oh, you connected.
Yeah.
Your connection. You see where your connections got you?
Man, just cut me down, man. I got you. Look. Just tell Dominic, man, I get the stolen money from the merchandise.
How long you been working, Doc?
6 years.
6 years,
man. Yeah.
It's a long time.
Yeah.
Long time to not cross a man. But you already know that, don't you?
Look, I don't know what you got, your fats got going on, man, but working this out, man. Just cut me loose, man. I'm better out on the streets.
The fact that you're still alive and Dominic ain't sent this to kill you until now lets me know that you should have already gotten his money. That's right. Right?
Yeah. Yeah, I got going on, man. Just cut it down. Just let me live.
I like promise you, Morty.
Promise.
I like you. Cool. You're my kind of guy. So I'm gonna make this quick.
Man, cut me down. My man, yo, wait. Yo, what are you doing, man?
You might want to close your eyes.
Crying.
Oh, that's funny.
Boys! Good to see you. How are you?
Good to see you too, boss. Wish I could say the same for you.
Oh, please, you have wannabe. The only thing I want to be is put my foot up your ass.
All the time. All right, that's enough. That's enough, goddammit.
Jaw goes down, man.
Damn it, you three. Larry, Moe, and Curly over here. You guys are killing me.
So important that you had to have all three of us down there.
Well, I need all three. I need you to make a run for me.
Run? With these two? I'd rather have my Johnson in the meat grinder than go anywhere with these two.
Well, that could be arranged. You see, there was a shipment a few weeks ago down at O'Shea's. The crates had been sitting there for a few weeks waiting for the heat to die down.
Heat? What heat?
Well, the original shipment. It was tagged. The cops were on to it. So the idiot Jimmy Tools goes in to get the crates out. And he forgets a few of them. Well, it's a three-man job. One transport van, one man in the car running point. Rev, you're going to be in the car running point.
I got this girl, and I'm in the car. We were back parking the parking lot.
You drive us though.
You know, well, you know, you got to do what you
biscuits and gravy. Always with the jokes. I'm gonna play for you two today. Episodes. Gotta pick up a couple vehicles. If you mess this up.
What the hell's your problem anyway?
You're my problem.
Oh, that sucks. And what the hell makes you so high and mighty, huh? Last time I checked, you had as much dirt under your nails as the rest of us did. Rev.
See, Lord blessed me with two good hands.
You want to find out how blessed they really are? Huh?
You test your faith?
Oh, I could use some repentance today, Reverend.
All right, that's enough. That's enough of the schoolyard stuff, all right? We got a job to do. You hold up your end, we'll hold up our end. Let's cut the measuring contest out, because I'm the biggest. Let's go, man.
Lucky Sunday, motherfucker.
I was wondering if you'd be down to ride. But tonight I don't wanna be alone. But tonight I don't wanna be alone. Shorty was five, was it hitting four? Let's go to my spot and get it in.
Ah, cheers, lads. How the hell are you?
Hey, Bobby, how's life in the fast lane?
Good diet. Ain't found the on-ramp yet, you know? So, Clyde, dog, how the hell are you?
Still breathing the air the good Lord gave us.
Amen. Good. Shipment's in the back. Come on, follow me.
Well, there it is.
Shut up.
Pretty hard, right?
Yes, indeed.
What happened to Jimmy Tools after all that?
Nothing. Too close to boss man's heart.
You know, all that family values crap. He's a good man. He really is. You know, all that family hospitality, that's going to be the best of him if he ain't careful.
Well, let's load it up.
Thank you.
License and registration.
Just another brother getting pulled over, man.
License and registration, sir.
Ooh, I got a sir this time. I didn't know it was illegal to transport white people in this country.
I'm gonna ask you one more time. License and registration. Thank you, Mr. Willis.
I don't remember the last time a brother and a white boy transported a bomb in the name of the Taliban.
It's just probably routine, man.
Yeah, well, something don't feel right about it. Tell you what, if it gets too hot, I'm frying some bacon. You dig?
I got your back, bro. I'm gonna need you to step out of the vehicle.
You mind filling me in on what's going on, my good man?
I'm gonna ask you one more time. Get out of the vehicle.
You got it. This better be good because my lawyer's better. Got me one of those bulldog Johnny Cochran types.
That means you too, Cuba. Well, so much for bedside manner. Well, well, well. What do we have here? Looks like it's our lucky day, partner.
Indeed it does, partner.
Better watch the screen you put your filthy hands on.
And you better watch who you're talking to, street trash.
Looks like we're going to confiscate this evidence, right? It's going to get put to good use, don't worry. Why don't you two take a couple steps back? I don't want nobody to get shy here now, do we?
I'm about to take care of
you. You're about to what?
It ain't work.
You should listen to your buddy there, big boy. He knows what he's talking about. And say thanks to, what's his name? Dominic? Next time, be on time so we don't have to track it.
Fertility runs deep in the family, all right? You know, the boy, he just got out of rehab and needed a job. And you two, you'd be lucky to have my mojo when you get my age. Shoot. Come on, help me load this stuff up.
So how do you suppose they knew that the truck was carrying and that it was registered in Dominic's name?
Registration?
Nah, Fats is too tight for that.
Think with the road?
Nah, he's a vindictive son of a bitch. But he's not that stupid. He wouldn't risk getting pinched either. I don't know, it just doesn't add up. One car, and no tail on the point, man? Something's not right.
But I'm not so sure about the new guy. What's his name? B? Brian?
Yeah, Joe's getting a little up in age. He lets things fly by, but he wouldn't let nothing like that slip by.
Yeah, well, I guess you're right. Well, so how do we go about smoothing this over with Fats?
Cake and milkshake.
Get out of your damn mind. You something to eat?
No, I'm hungry.
Good morning, Vanessa.
Good morning, Captain.
Thank you.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, I've got that file, Captain.
Savage, huh?
Yeah.
That name's fitting.
Not much on him other than the acquittal for the manslaughter charges. Other than that, he seems to lead a model life.
I mean, he wasn't even removed from the Baptist Ministry Church.
He resigned after the hearing.
But you need to learn that there's more to this young man than meets the eye. Yeah. And what about these two jokers that seem to admire Savage's wardrobe attire?
Oh, yeah. I got nothing on these two. I searched all the databases. Nothing.
Nothing, huh? Keep looking. All right?
Roger that. Okay.
In the meantime, pay someone a little visit. Don't sit down.
Do either of you have anything even remotely interesting to tell me?
We picked up a tail. But I think they were on us long before they ever tagged us.
Oh, do you think? Tell me, at what point did either of you realize that you had a tail on you?
Dom, we didn't see it coming. Alright, all we lost was the money.
Really? That's it? All they got's money? You freaking kidding me? I had my head examined dealing with the two of you. Do you even know why they were tailing you? They didn't want the guns. If they did, the two of you would have been pinched. And right about now, you'd be sharing a 6x6 cell with a big black buck calling you sweetheart right about now. All right. You are the best that I have. I know that. I don't want to see anything happen to the two of you. But don't go mistaking my kindness for weakness. Do you understand?
Hey, you got it.
Yeah, I appreciate it. No, thanks a lot. Yeah, you too. All right, bye-bye.
So what'd you find out?
Well, I got this from downtown from an informer who took the 911 call.
911 call?
Yeah, it came from that address, that phone number.
This is Joe's.
Said the caller was a young guy. Pinned you two right away. Didn't make much sense, though.
Give a name?
Said that he wanted to speak to the officer who pulled you over.
Sounds to me like a junkie trying to make good on his parole.
Is that it?
That's all I got, fellas.
Thanks, Rich.
See you later, brother.
Call last night about something important?
It's about to stop from the other day.
It was a setup from the get-go. More or less an inside job. Somebody close tipped them off.
So, what's that got to do with me?
It was Brian.
Brian? Brian! Come on, man. Get the hell out of here. That boy's got problems, but he knows better than to do something like that. What's this? This is the phone to the back of the bar, in the address.
Yeah, we know. Someone from your joint made the call. We had Rich confirm it with 911 dispatch.
It don't make no sense. Why would he do something like this? I just gave the kid a job to get him back on his feet.
Look, Joe, we can't have any loose ends around here. And Dominic works very hard to keep this all anonymous.
So you want me to kill family, huh? My brother and I have had some problems, but this is just far out there.
I think there's a detective involved too. I think he's been keeping tabs on us around town.
Jeez, Brian, and I took him in like a son.
Joe, no loose ends.
Thanks for meeting you, boys.
I know that you're both very upset. Hell, we all are.
That doesn't even begin to describe how I feel.
That's why we thought, maybe we could just tie up some loose ends.
Listen, this whole thing,
it's just not good for business.
Listen, I know you're both upset. Hell, we all are.
Did you talk to Joe?
Yeah, we talked to Joe. We gave him the information Richard gave us.
How'd he take it?
Not well. What do you understand that part of it?
Just give me a minute to think. You two better be right about this. I don't want you to do a thing until I've had the time to sit down and just think about what to do. We have to be real careful how we handle this thing. Richard.
Yes, Tom.
I want you to keep tabs on our two golden boys there. I don't want them flying off the handle on this thing.
Right.
So what are you thinking?
I think we need to get to that piece of shit before it gets heavy around here.
Yeah, but what about Dom?
What about him?
I don't think he wants us to move on this one.
You know what Dom means when he says, let me think about it, right?
Yeah, what he means is he wants to come up with a plan so he can act like he sorted this all out.
Exactly. So I say we do what we do best, then go back to Dom and come up with a scenario that makes him think he thought of it.
Nah, man. Not this one. His ties with Joe are too tight. He's gonna second guess it. We gotta act on this now.
You know I got your back no matter what.
Yeah, no doubt. I gotta hit up the club. Sound changes in time, felt my own range, said to feel like a break outside.
Do you understand the magnitude of what's just transpired here?
Hello! Is anybody here?
And who are you?
Detective Marcus Stone. And I was thinking about using your company for some exporting, is it?
Cut the crap, Stone. You want to tell me why you're really here?
I was in the neighborhood and I figured I'd stop in and say hello and just find out how the industrial side of our great city is doing.
Is that so, Detective?
So it is. And it's Captain, if I neglected to mention.
Oh, Captain! Well, since you don't have a warrant, and we've done nothing wrong, I normally tell you to get the hell out of my face. But, Richard, why don't you show our distinguished guest a tour of the warehouse? Yeah.
That won't be necessary, Richard. I'll see you around, gentlemen.
Alright, I don't like that son of a bitch one bit. I want to see what you can find out about him.
You got it. I'll contact my source in the DA's office.
And get the car. I gotta go see Joe. I want you to take that file that you prepared and give it to Rev.
Yeah.
Table.
I need to talk to him alone.
Ooh, struggling turn.
Shut up.
Hey, I really need a favor.
I still don't have my drink yet. You are working, right?
Yeah, I'm working. You know what? I can't tell if you're just dense or really just a prick.
Ooh, now she is a sweet talker. Especially when she wants something.
Look, it's just a loan. Nothing that I can't pay back.
Just a loan, huh?
I really need this place. I don't know what I would do without it.
Well, maybe you should think about getting a legitimate job.
Come on, baby, please.
What is it exactly you think you've got that I haven't gotten already?
Are you into that?
Into what?
Watching.
No, no. Well, maybe.
Prick.
Come on. I'm just kidding. Don't make this any harder than it has to be.
I'll be home in a couple of days. I'm taking a couple of days off. Look, you knew how this was when I first started, okay? I gotta earn. Yeah, you too. My girl.
Now that is one gorgeous chef. And you better get back before you burn those eggs.
Well, nothing burns down now but you, baby.
Damn. Are you gonna get it?
Nope. It's my day off.
I thought it was your day off.
It is. I'm here with you.
Me and those burning eggs.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm up. Yeah, I got it.
So this is your work phone, I take it. And who is Clyde?
Come on, dog, pick up.
Nobody, just somebody from work. I gotta take this.
Yeah, you always gotta take this one.
Yeah. Got it. See you in third. I gotta go to work. I'll see you later.
Hey, Kevin. Go on home. Come back later for your shit. How we gonna do this?
Find them, make it quick, man.
Just pop, just like that.
You know this is in the best interest for all of us.
Look, I've been in the game for a long time. I know the deal.
You know where we can find him?
He's at some crack house, meth house, something like that. He done found his old demons.
You got the address?
It's 37 92nd, 37th Street.
Meet us there around 9 p.m., just the three of us.
Hey, boys. Please. Make this quick.
Yeah, hey, look, boys, this is Richard. Yeah, Dom says to lay low. Do not move forward with any business.
Well, well, well. Your sweetheart. Hey! Looks like somebody was having a little party. Let's go.
Sent y'all?
Tell him.
You could tell him yourself.
Get your damn stuff together. Let's get the hell out of here, kid.
Tell these men what they need to know.
Know what, man? I don't know nothing.
We know you tipped off the cops. All we want to know is what you told them.
I ain't tell the cops not a damn thing.
Tell them.
Now we can do this two ways. The hard way or my way. It's your choice.
Okay. What are you talking about the drug deal?
Drugs? What about the money and the guns?
What guns? It was just drugs Sonny was dealing. The suburbs. Heroin. I don't know nothing about no guns.
I don't want to hear about some damn two-bit drug dealer.
I told you, I don't know nothing about no damn guns. Uncle Joe!
Damn it, kid! I'm trying to help you out. All you had to do was stay clean. Uh-huh.
too hard, too tough, or just too stupid.
Now you got one more chance to tell me what I need to know. What are the names of the two cops that took our drop money?
I swear, I didn't know.
Now, it's done.
What now?
Go find us some dirty pigs.
Load them up.
Can't say it back, even though you do.
I'm leaving.
Okay. Oh, and listen, do not be late tonight. We have a romantic dinner.
Yeah? It's the occasion.
How many occasions?
Then every heart breaks. Now with the Holy Ghost, oh, I would feel, oh Lord, oh, I would feel well, people, they would be shouting, praise my God. I hear them steal in that little, oh,
I'm
that
one church
house. I don't know.
I guess. I should be back around 9. Lock the lights up before you leave.
Yeah, Rich said it came across the scanner, said they should be in this area. Ain't that
shit? It sure is. Well, 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 look at what we got here. Now this doesn't look like an approved entry.
Oh, man.
Look, man. Oh, man. Look, man.
just take the stuff.
Oh, we plan to.
Come on, man.
What you mean?
Come on, man.
Where the hell is the money?
Shut up! Get in here!
Where is it?
Now, I think that's quite enough. You boys put them guns down real slow, you dig?
Man, asked. If you did, oh, you've got to be kidding me.
Any word from Dog and Clyde yet?
No, but I do have some new information on the cops they were looking for.
What cops?
Put them guys down.
Okay. Put it down, Paul.
Now, you two, itchy scratchy, get the hell out of here. Now, you two boys are gonna have a seat, real slow. We'll talk some things over. All right?
Once I pulled him over and seized the money, my informant tells me that the 911 call was reporting a possible DUI.
Don't say anything. You tell him we're dead.
Would you shut up, McCall! Come on, man. I'll talk.
I told you. This man will take your soul and won't think twice about it.
What DUI?
I don't know.
It was a buddy of mine. We used to bar together.
What buddy?
He also says that the caller sounded like a white kid. He was specifically asking for Derek McCall and Jason Boyd.
So, in other words,
this was just a routine stop. It didn't have anything to do with the guns.
Interesting. Get Joe on the phone, yeah?
We met him at a bar, okay? He said that you two punked him, all right? He wanted to get you back, so he hired us.
Well, more than one way to skin a cat. What do you mean? No. There it is. Wise, I'll talk.
Richard still isn't answering. It's not like them to be out of the warehouse like this.
I agree. Somebody write about this.
Mm-mm.
Not at all.
How long I've been doing this?
I don't know. 20 years, I guess.
Yeah, about 20 years. It's actually amazing I'm still alive. 20 goddamn years! Never once have I had any of my guys go behind my back like this. Nobody has ever gone rogue. Now you two listen to me. You listen to me good. If this ever happens again, I'll cap you both myself.
Well,
done. We were just trying to do what's best. What's best? I tell you what's best. I tell you what jobs to do. I'll tell you when to do them. I'll tell you when to go to sleep. I'll even tell you when to take a damn piss. Understood? I love the both of you. You've both been like brothers to me. So here's what I've come up with. As retribution for all of your actions, I will be taking 40% of your next three jobs. Get out of here, I've got work to do. I said get the hell out of here.
This had to be done.
How long have we been working together?
20 long years. Well, 25 if you count the 5 years that you took care of me after my dad passed.
You know, in all this time, I ain't never had to take out a family member. I mean, we had our issues. Nothing ever escalated to this level.
Joe, if it's any consolation, I've had to whack a family member before.
Was it hard?
Nope. He was a prick. Here's to you, my friend.
Damn, I called you 15 minutes ago. Have you found out anything about these two jokers I had you looking into?
No, nothing yet. I checked in with internal databases again, and there's nothing. I contacted the DMV. There are no driver's licenses, no traffic tickets. So what's our next step?
I'm going to keep my eye on this Dominic Fats Barone. And I think it's time that we put these two into the system.
Well, Richard, I can always tell when you're thinking about something.
I just don't like the idea of appeasing Joe. I mean, getting rid of that kid was the best thing for him.
Look, I don't disagree with you.
Well, I just hope you know what you're doing on this one, boss.
Boss. Hey, it was work. Been on hiatus. Too long.
Work? There's no work. Not with that son of a bitch detective hanging around.
Why am I on the shelf? Is it because of those two idiots and their slip-ups?
You were on the shelf because I said you're on the shelf.
Sir. Boss. Oh. By the way, I didn't know working men were allowed side action.
What the hell are you talking about?
Word on the streets said your golden boy has a hospital's little hussy down at the club. They're dropping a few coins, trying to clear up her debt. Might want to check into that.
Shut the door on your way out. Richard! Get in here!
Yeah, boss.
Listen, I'm going to see Joe. I need to take over for a little bit.
Alright.
Call Clyde and Dog and tell them be here by 5 o'clock.
You got it.
You're a real funny guy this morning, huh?
Yeah. Let's just get the money over to the warehouse.
Thank you so much.
Alright, you two. We're gonna have to talk about the situation with Joe.
What's to talk about? We already took care of everything.
Not everything. No. He wants retribution now for your indiscretions.
Okay, well, we'll give him a little kickback for our next few jobs.
It's not gonna be enough. Joe's a longtime friend. And you two really screwed things up by going behind my back the way you did.
Well, Dom, we were just trying to...
That's enough. I already spoke to Joe, and I'm gonna take care of everything that he needs. What you two are gonna do is you're gonna go to his place around 6 o'clock, and you're gonna give half of what's in that bag to him. Capiche?
Yes, sir.
Oh, and when you get there, Joe has something for the two of you. Yeah, Joe. Yeah, it's Dom. Yeah, they'll be over around 6 o'clock tonight. Mm-hmm. Is everything going to be ready for him? Good. Yeah.
Doesn't take much to tell you got something on your mind, partner.
You ever feel like you're just being stalled, running a rat race?
Set up or something?
Nah, nothing like that. I mean, if Dom wanted to take us out, we wouldn't even hear it coming. It's just like somebody's stalling us, you know?
I wouldn't put too much thought into it, man. Probably just got his wires crossed, you know?
Right. Whoever thought we'd get to the day where you'd be the voice of reason?
Things change, man. Things change.
Hey, fellas. How you doing? That was a hard thing for me to do. Now I gotta live with that. So long.
What's all this about?
Show me. Come on.
Retribution's great. There's your retribution. Go ahead, take the hood off.
Sorry, I didn't think it was gonna happen. I just wanted my boys to harass me.
See, that's all I want.
Nothing personal. Just business.
What did he just say?
It's just business.
Now the other part.
What?
quite a bit, nothing personal.
I should have known.
Should have known what?
I was told today that a friend of mine had died. I laughed so hard, then I cried. He had a good humor, always could make me smile. Too bad he's gone for a while. I love many and I have been a stubborn fool. I was jealous.
Finally awakened. So pleasant. I am General Maxim Gorskov. Vodka?
Kiss my ass.
Not going to kill you right away. In fact, I'm going to give you a chance.
I said, you can kiss my ass.
But there's no way to speak to a man who holds your life in the balance. We've offered to let you keep it. Under stipulation, of course.
I'm gonna tell you a goddamn thing, you animal.
You think I want your information? I don't want your information.
I want suffering. Your suffering.
You'll bleed slowly.
Just make it quick.
You and I, my friend, were not so different. You cut through 13 of my men like it was nothing. But I saw it. I saw something.
What exactly is it you think you saw?
It's that look in your eye. You're no more a man and no less a demon than I am. And you enjoy what you do. It's like a switch, no? A switch you can't turn off. It's a switch neither of us can turn off. Siet! Cut them down. Take them through the wolves. I gave you my word I would not kill you. But the wolves... They'll pull you apart piece by piece. Ah! I give you my word I will not kill you. They'll pull you apart.
piece by piece.
Sir, we found him. He's over here.
Cleaned up, and I'll talk to you later.
It's on the prevail, cowboy.
Let's go.
Yeah. Got it. That was Rich. He says we gotta go get our next assignment.
Black.
Yep. Just like you like it.
So what's the plan?
No plan. I got a feeling if we just relax and lay back,
those two clowns will fall right on our doorstep.
Anything on our misguided mailman?
Yeah. Name's Daniel Harvey. Suspect of stealing mail from his roots. He's a small timer.
This is what I want you to do. I want you to put a unit along his route today. Tell them don't make a move until I tell them.
How you want to do this one?
I'll take the mark, hit him on the inside, and see what information I can get out of him.
And I'll take the van and see if I can get that envelope.
Let's make this happen.
All right.
Yeah. Ugh, come on. I'm just stopping for lunch.
Listen to me very carefully.
carefully. You will answer my questions with a nod or shake your head. Because if you don't, I'm gonna blow your brains all over those cabinets. Nod if you understand.
Yeah, I understand.
I told you, a nod or a shake. Let's try this again.
Got it.
What's up, Cap? What?
You took a lever, just one. Do you know where it is?
I've taken a lot of letters. I don't know. Which one are you looking for?
Get up. Now that's just embarrassing.
Oh, come on.
Sit tight.
You got anything sharp, dangerous, gonna hurt me, poke me?
Nothing sharp, but something definitely dangerous.
You fucking funny guy? Crazy. You know what's a felony tamper with the mail?
Like, I need this right now.
Okay, man, okay, I'm sorry, I got scared.
You had me running down this alley to end up with what, a dead end?
Well. Look who we have here. No name, no record, not even a parking ticket. But you will talk.
Not without my attorney.
So, we're gonna play that game, huh? You know I can throw your ass right back there in that cell?
On what charges?
Let's see. Failing to cooperate with the police investigation. Failing to provide identification. Well, yeah. Breaking into a government vehicle.
Now, you and I both know those charges won't stick.
But isn't Richard,
or is it Dick?
Which one would you rather be called?
It's gotta be my lucky day.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Look, if we're done here, you have nothing. No charges that could stick against my client.
So, unless you plan on bringing charges, my client is free to go.
No need for threats. You're right. You two gentlemen are free to go.
Have a good day, officer.
You too.
What the hell's going on here, Dom?
Listen. I want you to go home, all the way home. And I want you to relax for a little bit while I try to figure
this out. Go home? Relax?
I am land and under sea, oh, it's
they say there's honor among thieves. And when you make a deal with the devil, you just make sure you know who has your back. Because sometimes, sometimes you just never see it coming.
Ah! Shit, dog! God damn it!
With friendship, there are always sacrifices. So when you look back at it, just make sure you got as much out of it as you put in. I know I did. Honor among thieves.
Follow me, no designer quote, and open your mind with the vocab and let it live in your lab. No need to pack your bags, your itineraries everywhere we at. Like every time we chat, please to ticket your emotions. I don't cause tears, but help you to create oceans. Always riding first class, never need a upgrade. Let me stamp your passport, secure you extended days. In sun rays, you pick the place, I'll make the time. A little faith is all it takes, put it in my hands. Can't wait for them to touch on my controls and let the destiny unfold. Just secure yourself, but have no fear. Let me take you on a trip, we don't need landing gear. Just secure yourself, but have no fear. Let me take you on a trip, we don't need landing gear.
Let's get the flow in, let's get the flow in. Put your body in motion, put your body in motion.
Seventh heaven, another level, I break it down into segments. One, they call it four, let's play and don't stop. Two, the elevation a couple of miles high. Three, you see the stars when I'm swimming in your seas. Go ahead and spread your wings so I can...